Hi, in this video I'm gonna play with my first show laser. This little cube called the LaserCube was donated to my channel by Wicked Lasers. This is way more complicated than the laser pointers I'm used to handle, but still easy to use. I will try to show you a fraction of what it can do, how it works, and even apply some science to test the lasers in it. Show lasers are meant to be seen, but make sure that no one ever will be able to look directly into the beam or specular reflections of it. Don't let the laser cube's tiny size fool you. This is a class 4 laser, the highest laser hazard class there is, so use laser safety goggles when burning and popping with a steady beam. You'll see what I mean later. Let's start with a closer look on the laser before firing it up. It is a small heavy 10 cm cube. It feels rock solid. Everything but the on-off button is made of metal, thick metal. All six sides are 3 mm thick, making it seem overbuilt, but I guess it is necessary as one big heatsink to cool the powerful lasers and electronics inside it. Very nice build quality. We live in a plastic world, so it's just nice to feel thick cold metal like this for once. But it is of course the components inside the cube that is the most interesting. There are 3 lasers inside it, a red, green and blue, making this a full color RGB laser. At the time of this recording, the laser cube isn't released yet, but I've been told that the lasers in it are as powerful as the bigger 1W laser dock already available. That's quite a lot of photonic power for such a small show laser. Could this be real? Luckily, with the kind help from my patrons, I've bought a laser power meter so we can test it. Thanks to all my patrons for making this possible. It is not recommended to fire a focused powerful beam onto the sensor. The laser can burn the needle coating on the sensor, so at first I mounted a focusing lens on the laser. After the focal point, the beam will be spread wider, lowering the power density, making it less destructive. I'm using the free software LaserOS from Wicked Lasers to control the laser. For a steady beam at full power needed here, the pop program is the most fun. Except it will only fire at full power for a limited time for safety's sake. It reached 727 milliwatts. Not bad, as it was clearly still climbing when the program turned the laser off. Still, I would like to go higher. The program won't let me fire for longer, but some power is also lost with the extra lens. Here, you can see a lot of light being reflected by the lens. Light that never reached the sensor. After some calculations, I convinced myself that the sensor could cope with the focus beam for a short time. I don't recommend doing this, but here we go. With the power meter calibrated for 450 nanometers, the strongest single wavelength from the laser cube, it reached 855 milliwatts. At a more central 540 nanometers for all wavelengths, it reached 871 milliwatts and was clearly still climbing fast. If the lasers and power sensor were given more time to heat up, and we account for the inevitable loss in the internal optics of the show laser, I believe the lasers perform to spec. Nice! Just under 1W may not sound like much, but it's intense. I will shut up and let the laser speak for itself. Thank you. show lasers will never replace true laser cutters and engravers. The beam from a show laser is hitting the target at an angle, but it is always fun to burn stuff with a laser, and I hope this gives you an idea of how powerful this cube is. I even managed to burn a spot in my lightly colored wallpaper with the beam turned on way too long in a balloon popping test. Whoops. Now, how do they manage to combine three lasers to one powerful and colorful beam and move it around like this? If you have ever played around with laser pointers of different colors, you know it is fairly easy to point them at the same spot to mix their colors. Here, I use a red and a green one to make a yellow dot, but it's not a yellow beam. This seems physically impossible to make since the lasers need to be in the exact same place at the same time, pointing in the same direction. You can, of course, point the lasers directly at each other or make them reflect into each other. I suck at it handheld, but you get the point. However, it will overheat the lasers and can't be used to protect the combined beam away from the lasers. The red laser even turns off when the green one hits it directly. So how do they combine three laser beams inside the show laser? The trick is special mirrors called dichroic mirrors. I have two large examples here, a red and a green one. In short, these let one color pass but reflect the other visible colors. That's exactly what we need to combine the beams. Here are two examples. There's only a tiny window into the laser cube, but it's enough to see the optics used. They combine the three laser beams using two dichroic mirrors and then move the beam using two scanners. Let me use a diffraction grating to visualize how they achieve different colors. Actually, with the diffraction grating out, let's quickly test the wavelengths of the three lasers. As shown in my previous video, the wavelengths will increase a little as the laser heats up, but it looks like the laser cube uses the same wavelengths as the laser dock. Alright, with all this optical trickery, the laser cube will project a ton of different shows. It would take hours to go through all the possibilities. Instead, I suggest you download the free software to an Android device and try it yourself. On the screen, you can see what the laser would project, even without the laser. Just search for Laser OS on Google Play. I must admit, I am impressed by how much they managed to cram into this tiny enclosure. Did I mention that it even has a battery inside it? So all you need for a laser show anywhere is the laser cube, an Android smartphone, and a USB cable. I will update the description under the video as more details about the laser cube are released. Thanks to all my patrons, I finally have a laser power meter and I owe it all to you. This opens new possibilities and will improve my future laser videos. Thank you so much. And of course, thanks to Wicked Lasers for sending me the laser cube. It is just a dream to have a portable plug and play show laser running on battery. Easy and quick to set up, yet very capable. Bravo! Thank you for watching. Bye for now.